All right, hey, so what's up, guys? All right, just a quick test and review of this new IPS touchscreen I found on Aliexpress. I haven't seen too much stuff on it, and it uses the ST7789 for the LCD driver, and it's got, for the capacitive touch, it uses this FT6336. This is a newer chip. Actually, the Adafruit did, I think, like a FT6236, but this is a newer one, and I haven't seen too much stuff with this. Okay, so first off, they actually list the chips it uses on the PCB, which is great, because I hate trying to track that stuff down, and they like to sell you stuff that they don't even know what they're selling. So this is great. So on the LCD side, you're all set. The Adafruit library works great with it. They already have one that works with this ST7789. For the touch side, which again is capacitive, which is great, it uses this new chip, this FT6336. So looking at the data sheet, this is pretty impressive. So they actually put a MCU on this chip, and or on the, I don't know, it's on the LCD somewhere. But yeah, so they actually put a chip in here, so which is kind of impressive for how small it is and for how cheap it is. It uses, it could do 1 point, but it could also do 2 points. So that's like a one finger touch or two finger touch. I'll show you that later. And it looks like it's rated for 2.8 volts to 3.6 volts, but I'm using an ESP32, so I'm fine. And I'll link down below my GitHub where you could check out the code yourself and test things out. All right, so let's check it out. So yeah, the screen's only an LCD. It's not OLED or anything like that, but the colors look pretty nice. They kind of pop. And it's IPS, so the viewing angles are pretty good. And the best part is it's capacitive. So a capacitive IPS screen for this price is pretty good. Okay, so again, for the LCD, I'm using the Adafruit library, which I'll show you where you can get it later. And for the touchscreen, I'm using this library here. And there's actually a few libraries out there, but they're all kind of wonky. And this is the only one that I could get to work quite stably. And it works pretty nice. So what I have set up here, I just made these color buttons. And every time you press a button, it will register. And I just set it up so if you hold it down, so you could see how that works. And then I set it up, we could show the X and Y, so I can kind of move my finger around. There is one thing that I need to check out later, but I think if you kind of, I don't know, move your finger around a lot like this, it will register like something on the Y. It'll show up. It takes a while to do it, I think it works pretty well. I think if you're just doing single touches, it's fine, but if I start, I don't know, if I keep moving like this, there, it will, the Y will register like a 3 or a 0 or something like that. So I have the setup is if I could toggle the color button modes or just the XY mode when I touch up here, so when X and Y is up here. But that's, I need to check. I don't know if that's with the I squared C or what, but it's pretty hard to repeat now. Like it takes a while. And my purpose for this was just to do these single button presses. But I think if you are looking for something maybe to draw with, this could be kind of tricky. I don't know. Yeah, I don't know what's up with that. I don't know if it's with the I squared C bit or what. But I think if you're just pressing buttons, which is my plan for it, I think this will work. I don't have any experience with other touchscreens. I don't know how super accurate they are, but this is pretty accurate. So yeah, it's just that, again, I need to do this for a while to get it to do something like that. But I did just do the, I did do the single press. If I just tap, like I spent, I don't know, I tried doing this for like 5 or 6 minutes and I never got a fake, I never got a wrong read. It's just actually when I am, you know, holding my finger down and moving it around like this, that I get that. So I don't know. It could be with that. Could be with the. I don't know. But again, just pressing like this works fine. So just really quick, yeah, so you could find, I had my GitHub down below. You could check down the code if you do get one of these screens. All right, and if you guys don't know how to get all this going, all you need to do is you need to install the Adafruit. You need to make sure the Adafruit graphics library is installed, and if it's not on there already, you could just, you could find it here. And you also need to install the Adafruit ST7789 library. And you could find that here. As for the touch library, actually there are quite a few libraries for the 6336, but they're all pretty wonky, and I think I've tried pretty much all of them and they don't work, or they cause lots of problems. So the one that I got to work and work reliably is this one here. And again, all links down below. Now, you can't get this through the Arduino IDE, so you need to just go to the GitHub, and you could download the zip file here, unzip it, and then you want to stick it in your Arduino folder under libraries, and that's where I put this here. And yeah, oh, I will show you the. Two-finger touch thing, and you could see it on the serial monitor there, but it does register the two-finger touch. The problem is if you have your fingers too close together, the second touch doesn't register, so but it is catching 2 points, so that's pretty cool. But I don't know if you want to do some like pinch to zoom type stuff or whatever, you're gonna have to do some software stuff to make sure it runs properly. But again, for the price, this is pretty good. One other thing, so for the fonts, I just had this updating, so it looks pretty seamless right there. But as for the regular LCD library, which is pretty common for all LCDs or OLEDs or whatever, it's still drawing everything. So again, with this, you can't see it. It's kind of imperceptible, the drawing, but if I reset here, you'll see how these buttons get drawn. Yeah, so it's like that. So I wanted to do it when you press a button, it would just invert the color so it shows your the button was registered, but it actually draws it and you could kind of see it. So it's not too good looking, but again, that's kind of hardware issue. That's where we're at with this stuff. But for this price, you can't argue with it. So if you want to test it out, actually, I'm going to add, it's actually an affiliate link down below. If you don't want to use my affiliate link, you could just search for the screen with those chips, the 7789 and the 6336. Again, I'm not vouching for this. For me, it works great, but with Aliexpress, yeah, you need to use your due diligence. And if you ever order anything off there, yeah, you got to test it right when you get it. And if there are any problems, send it back. So at least Aliexpress has a good return policy. But yeah, I can't, you know, I'm not going to vouch for this product, but for me, it's working great now. I can't say it's going to work forever. But I think for this price, it's pretty good. One more thing, if you do use the link, yeah, make sure you choose the IPS touch because they got different models here. They got no touch and there's just this TFT touch. And yeah, I don't know. I think the IPS touch is pretty good. So take it for what it is. But all right, guys. Oh, but again, yeah. Link down to my GitHub files down below if you want to try. But yeah, all right, guys, that's it. Take it for what it's worth. Okay, I'll see you later. Take care.